All right, we're back at Mike's. I've finished up my bids a little bit early, so I thought I'd swing in and finish up at least the inside portion of the system. It's still like 0 degrees out, so I might do the outside tomorrow or maybe even next week. But we've got some results. We've got 20 hours of data from our eco trackers from when I reset them last night once we got the system up and running. So in the well room, we initially had like 15 picocuries in there. We are now down to 0.8. In the basement here, where we initially were 3.2 picocuries, we're now down to 0.6. In the kitchen, we were initially at 2.1, and now we're down to 0.8 over the last 20 hours. And in that entryway, we were initially 1.7, and we are now down to 0.9. So we're gonna call it good right there. If it's 0 degrees out, or it's like 18 below this morning, if the radon system, this radon system can keep the radon levels below one when it's 20 below, that's a great sign. So I don't think we're gonna have to do any additional work to treat those other, the slab here to my right, or treat the entryway or anything like that. And that would be a totally different system. So for tonight, I'm gonna focus on putting in the alarm and the manometer, and then I will probably try to seal these cracks. And then, like I said, we'll do the outside portion of it later. So I'm gonna get to work. All right, so now I'm ready to add the alarm and the manometer. We are using the Radonaway RSA-1 radon system alarm. This is a battery-powered alarm. So I'm gonna start by drilling a hole. I like to use a laser. That's what this red line is. Just gives it a nice clean install, everything's lined up. So I've got a 11/16 bit here. And then this alarm, the newer version is better apparently, but this is like the last one I have of the old version. I'm gonna drill a hole just above this battery so that the tubing going from here to here doesn't kink. So we've got a hole for my tubing to come through. I'm going to take the one that's got this, what do you call that, concave shape. That's gonna slide over like so. And then I'll peel that adhesive off. Apparently they had issues with their first version of this, that the mold oil, where these are manufactured, they weren't taking the mold oil off or cleaning it. So this 3M sticky tape was coming off of the plastic, so they were falling off the radon system. So I don't know if that's fixed now. I'm assuming it is, but I don't know if it is on this version. So I'm gonna screw this to the pipe so that it cannot fall off. I've got this cut to 1 5/8 inch, and this should allow it, not allow it to kink. So I'm gonna slide it on that upper little barb up here. So that's on and solid. And then I'll slide it on that barb I drilled the hole for there. So that's how I have it. This can't kink. The new version has like a molded piece that would make this work without kinking. And that was the issue, is that this tube would kink and then the alarm wouldn't work. So it's gonna mount to the pipe like this. So you can see that's kind of convex or concave. And then I'll put a couple screws in this as well. So it looks like I use a 1/8 bit for this. And then I just got a 3/4 inch stainless steel screw. And now I'm ready for my YouTube manometer. So we've got that here. We get these from Radonaway. So there's what that looks like. We pull these out. You never leave these in. They're just for transportation. So throw these away. Otherwise your manometer will not read correctly. It takes about 10 minutes for this fluid to settle. So we're gonna pull it down just a little bit lower than zero. And that should be about right once it settles out. just has two screws. They're self-tappers, so we don't have to drill this out. So this tubing is 3/16 diameter, so we use a 3/16 drill bit for that. So it's gonna go in one side like this, doesn't really matter which side. And you want this tubing to go in below this so that water cannot enter the manometer. Whereas if I went in up here, we could get condensation getting in the manometer. So I drill it just about like this. And then I angle it up slightly just to lessen the chance of water gets in there. And I don't want to go too angled or otherwise I can't get my pitot tube in there to get a CFM reading. So just slightly up. We'll just activate this alarm once we get the system up and running. So now I'm gonna do some sealing. All right, I almost forgot. I gotta secure this pipe every 4 feet horizontally and every 10 feet vertically. So before I do that, I'm just gonna mount it. So green treat here. I'm just gonna seal this. I'll seal it outside too, but I won't be able to have access to this in a couple minutes. All right, so if you're attaching to concrete, you gotta be green treat. So I just had a small scrap of green treat out in the van. So I'm going to do something like that. All right, so you wanna use deck screws or treat screws that you can use in treated wood. Apparently if you use like a drywall screw, it, I think the green treat will cause it to corrode. So I just got a 3-inch 2-hole strap and I bent these up to fit around this 4-inch. Fit in here. All right, so I'll level that up and then I'll just drill a couple tap cons in there. I think these are 2 3/4 inch and it gives you maybe, I don't know, half of it goes into the concrete block. So it's all threads. With tapcons, you're gonna make sure you don't over-tighten them, otherwise they strip. All right, now I think I'm ready to do sealing. So I'm gonna clean up some of this stuff, get it out of my way, and then I'll prep for sealing. So I'm just gonna wire brush all my floor to wall joints. We've got some penetrations for all the water lines. They run up to barns and stuff. So I'll prep all that stuff, clean this up. This is from the splash when we cored the hole. Get it all prepped, and then we'll get to sealing. All right, now I've got everything prepped. I wire brushed it. I got everything vacuumed. Now I'm gonna seal everything. We use a product called Radon Sealant. Here's what we've got here. We'll put links to all this stuff in the description as well. So it's by Tight Bond, and we use this to seal everything like on the concrete. So I like to cut an angle on the tip, and then I mark with a Sharpie where that high point of my tip is so I can kind of keep it orientated correctly so I'm not oozing stuff out everywhere. And then before sealing for PFE, what we have right now is 396 pascals negative in the well room here. The one out in the middle there, we have 10 pascals negative, and the far one in the corner, we've got 5.3 pascals negative. So we might see these go up a little bit or more negative once we do some sealing. So the sealing next to the suction point is the most critical. And there's not much of a floor to wall joint here, but there's something. So then I just smear it all out with my finger. Usually I'll do about 10 minutes worth of sealing. And that gives, after about 10 minutes, this kind of starts to set up too much where it's harder to smooth out. So we had 396 on this wall room. I'm willing to bet that got a little bit better. And we're still gonna seal up like those pipe penetrations through the block, so that may or may not help us. So we had 396 on this one before. Now we went up to 410. This was 5.3 and this was around 10. So we gained a little bit on these so far. Now we're gonna see all these cracks. So I like to try to inject it into the crack and then I'll come back and smooth this out with my finger. So if this was unfinished, we could go around and get the floor to wall joint too, just like we did in the well room, but clearly it's finished. Sometimes that joint back there is pretty significant. I've bid a couple jobs a day where you could slide a nickel back there. So if you're going to be remodeling, that would be my biggest advice is seal. Go back to where I first started from because this is most set up. Some people like to use a putty knife for this. And then if I missed a spot, I can just kind of move it in with my finger like that. Now we just gotta foam those penetrations. And I gotta wipe my fingers off. It's probably more of a radon entry point that's not being addressed by the radon system because that's below the slab. And we're done inside. All I've got to do is once we get the fan and everything installed permanently, we'll put our label on here, our system tag, and I'm gonna give Mike a copy of all the numbers that I wrote down for my pressure field extension, and then his OM&M plan will attach here as well. But that's a wrap for today. Are you a radon mitigation contractor that would like to be more confident when giving estimates or installing a mitigation system? Would you like to reduce callbacks and stand out from your competitors? Would you like to offer more value to the families you serve? If so, we have a hands-on radon course coming up where we are going to focus on optimal mitigation, pressure field extension testing, suction point placement, pipe size, fan selection, and the effects of sealing. To sign up for our course, click the link in the description below. I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for watching.